Hello. Today we are talking about the WhereBulkNotContains method from the Entity Framework Extensions Library, created by our team at ZZZ Projects. First, how to filter entities not contained from an existing list with Entity Framework? Filtering entities by excluding all items from an existing list can sometimes be very useful. For example, you deserialize a JSON file into a list of customers with the customer IDs populated, and you want to retrieve customers not contained in this list to delete them. A frequent solution is using the contains method to retrieve those customers, such as seen here. However, this solution has several limitations. It only supports basic types like int or GUID. The list of IDs is limited due to SQL limitations. It doesn't support surrogate key or other complex scenarios. To solve those limitations, the WhereBulkNotContains method has many advantages. It allows using any list type like basic type, entity type, anonymous type, expando object. It allows for an unlimited amount of items. And you can specify a custom join with one or many properties. The WhereBulkNotContains method is similar to the WhereBulkContains method, but it filters entities not contained, or exclude, instead of contained, or include. The WhereBulkContains method filters entities to include entities from the list, which is an inner join statement. The WhereBulkNotContains method filters entities to exclude entities from the list. It is a WhereNotExists statement. If you are wondering, how can you use the method WhereBulkNotContains? The most basic scenario is passing a list to the WhereBulkNotContains method. The WhereBulkNotContains method will filter entities to exclude those contained in the list. The join statement will use the default entity key if none is provided customer ID. You can also specify a custom join clause with one or many properties using a lambda expression. Finally, you can specify a custom join clause with one or many properties using a list string. You can specify a custom join clause with one or many properties using a param string.
I hope this answers your questions about the WhereBulkNotContains method. You can learn more by reading the WhereBulkContains documentation. Both methods have the same features and limitations. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel for more information about the Entity Framework Extensions Library. And you can always contact us directly at info@zzzprojects.com. Thank you for your time. And let us know in the comment. Would the WhereBulkNotContains be helpful in your projects? Have a great day, see you soon.